Music Radio, WLAS.
To be with you, Rush Limbaugh, the EIB Network, and...
Good morning, everybody.
Hello, friends. Welcome to the show.
What's up, beer drinkers? We got another great show for you again this week.
Here's Dan Hampton and Ed O'Brien.
Hey, it's Conrad Thompson, and you're listening to...
All right, you know why we're here. So if you have any doubts or reservations, now is the time to say so. No one will think any less of you. Because once you enter this family, there's no getting out.
This is where this gets difficult.
It is the Lingus Mafia podcast, show number 516. Never missing a week, as we always do. And we're here to give you a bunch of nonsense, is what we like to do. I'm the boss. My name is Cav Manning. I am along with my consigliere. That is Frosty Walnuts.
What do you hear? What do you say?
And the bookie, the underboss. That is Gregorio.
Buonasera, gentlemen.
Got a good gambling thing. Went finally. You see, I fucking abstained for a little bit. And fucking finally, and then it fucking popped finally.
You got a good tip.
I just, that Troy West fucking came through, and I was like, fuck it, they look all right. And then there's a guy who is 15-0 every day, puts a fucking MLB out, and he hasn't fucking missed. So I'm like, I'm just waiting for his. And I don't think he does the thing where it's like, where yesterday was the fucking nail biter and it was Mariners and White Sox. And I was like, of all teams, this is the one that's going to cost me the fucking thing. The White Sox, who can't win a fucking game, now they're going to win one. But as the radio station in Chicago always says, he calls it the Holmes maneuver because that's old Lawrence Holmes. He says, as soon as they get a lead, bet on the other team. Fucking every time. They were up by fucking four and they lost 8-4 with a grand slam in the ninth.
Good Lord.
I was fucking screaming. Yeah.
Is that where you're rocking the Mariners
jersey?
That's
why. I'm playing.
Is that your Ed Strange?
That is my Doug Strange. I don't know who Doug Ed Strange is.
I couldn't remember his first name.
That's the only reason I even know this fucking slob.
What was his first name? Was it Fred Strange?
Well, they're all strange to me. So I pay tribute Strangers to the Mariners, them too, to the Mariners, because they fucking helped me out. $230 off of 20. That ain't too fucking bad. That's a good one. So we're doing an experiment to start the show because you have to let it ferment. I realized this because I did this the other day and saw how it was. And it's been going around on Instagram or whatever the fuck else. And it's a pickle Pepsi, because you can go to Sonic and ask for a fucking pickle Pepsi. And the guy's like, fuck, I'm going to go to Sonic and ask and look like a fucking asshole. There's no such thing. Like, yeah. And I don't know how they do it other than I see chips of pickles into the thing. I don't know if they're pouring juice, anything. So what I do is I had those stackers. They're the longer ones, right? So I do pour the Pepsi in or the Dr. Pepper in there. Bitch, by the way, did you hear the number two soda in the fucking country is Pepsi has fallen out of second place.
Wow. Really?
It's fucking Dr. Pepper.
Oh, shit.
I don't know why.
I thought Diet Coke was number two. It used to be Coke, Diet Coke, and then Pepsi.
That ain't a fucking bad one. But they
said it was fourth.
Jesus Christ. Code Red is good. I know that. That's fucking some delicious shit. But sugar, like, up your ass. So I do a Dr. Pepper. I threw two slices of these chips in there. And I mean, like, a spoonful maybe of the juice. Like I did a splash. So it was very minimal. And you stir it around and take that first sip. You almost don't even know that there's anything different. It's not, it's nothing really. I let that fucker sit for probably an hour. And, you know, it's just sitting there, whatever, you know, and here and there you would take it to, and I'm like, it's getting more pickly by the fucking minute. Mm. So by the end of it, it's got a different taste. It's not horrible at all. I don't know if I'd be like, oh, I fucking got to go get a pickle fucking drink. Yeah, I got to fucking hurry up and go back. But I figure we would try this for the show. So if we want to start the show, you would try now. You would take that little sip. And then by the end of the show, you take another fucking sip. You see the difference. The funny thing is the pickle turned brown by the end of this thing, right? Mm-hmm. And I'm then eat the pickle. I love a pickle. I tickle my pickle even. I try this thing, and the fucking pickle's carbonated by the end of it. So you get a nice carbonated pickle. So
see, I thought the whole thing was about just changing the pickle with the Dr. Pepper. So I got me a little bowl instead of a cup. But
to do whatever. What? What are you going to – you have a soup?
No, I thought you scoop it out and then you eat the – that was the whole point.
Oh, you eat the pickle. No.
Yeah, that's it's the drink. The whole point is
– it's a drink.
With you're pickling the pickle with Dr. Yeah. Pepper.
No.
Yeah, that's what I thought the whole thing was. Because when you said it turned black, I'm like, oh, okay, so we
– No, because at Sonic, they just get a drink and it's inside. See, there's no chips, you know. So, well, I mean, anyway, you still drink it out of the fucking bowl. So what the fuck's the difference? Like a fool. You'd be fucking part Chinese.
Let me show put in here.
You got chips?
Yeah.
3-4 maybe. I'm going to throw two slices of, let's see, mine here. I walk around like Damon Wayans with this. Well, the young kids don't know
the
how
whole
that
deal, though.
Yeah, the whole entire deal, though. So I get two good slices, let them drip in there. And then I'm going to do this much of a fucking splash. Let's see. Here we go. Oh, that's maybe a little too much. Shit.
Ooh.
Who doesn't love a delicious pickle? All right, so
I know I keep on eating them.
So you give a stir, get a little bit of a sip right off the bat. See, okay. And it's still, even though that splash was in there,
yeah,
I barely taste the fucking pickle.
Right,
I barely taste the pickle. So now, let that fucker sit. We'll test it in. We'll test it in a half. There you go. We'll test it in a half hour, and then by the end of the show, we'll do again for the people on Patreon. We'll get the full experience at the end of this fucking pig. My fucking brother went to London.
For what? Oh, to go see the Mets?
Yes.
Wow.
And I go, why on earth? And then I say it's saying, I go, well, you jerk off to baseball, I told him. He's like... When I said about the Bears 100, right? And I'm like, oh, fuck it. He goes, oh, if the Mets had something like that, I would fucking totally fucking go. And I'm like, why? You know, I'm like, yeah, I like the Mets. I ain't going to no fucking convention for it and shit like that.
He said if the Cowboys did something like
See,
that.
See, that's the thing. He was like, no, the Mets over the Cowboys in a heartbeat. And I'm like, guy's a baseball guy. That's what he's into fucking baseball, which I can't tell you. But
was it how many games did he go to?
He just went to the first game.
Oh. Is it sold out?
Well, it's 50,000 people. Wow. So, I mean, I don't know what that fucking place holds. The second day was the same. It's packed. So,
were they doing the soccer chants? Were they doing phenomenal and all
they
that?
Weren't doing phenomenal as far as I heard. I watched it, and I was like, all right. Well, it was they got ass raped without lube the first game. And he's all, oh, I fly to I fly here for this. Exactly. And I'm like, yeah, well, what do you expect? They're playing the fucking – the best team in the National League, apparently, is the fucking Phillies. Which, how the hell that happened, but so, and then I'm like, oh, did you go to the other game? Like, I talked to him on Sunday, and he's like, no. I go, you went there for one and then fucking just turn around and go home? He's like, yeah. I'm like, fuck's wrong with you?
Wow.
So, and that was the game. Like, they fucking tied it and fucking won it in the extras at the end or whatever the fuck it was. You
First
know,
time he's ever been to London?
Yeah. Yeah. So, he took his daughter and... I'm like, oh, she's a Met fan. I go, she go to the fucking game? No, she's at the hotel. I want to yell it. I go, wow. What is going on here?
Oh, she go to his daughter, yeah.
She go to the Ferris wheel? What the fuck is going on? She's in high school. She ain't a fucking, I'm like, what? I mean, if she was fucking adult. Five, it'd be real fucking weird. But right. Like, I left her at home. I told her not to touch anything. Don't leave the bed.
Know of a bar he could have gone to?
I just thought it was so bizarre that he would take her there.
And then not take her to
the
game.
Isn't that the point? You're going to the game. But he met like some coworker or something that went too, and they just went to fucking watch. So I'm like, well, you missed the game that you should have fucking been at. And he said, of course, it's because I was at that fucking game. So it was fucking shit. Have you guys looked into getting the new college football game? Anybody excited for that? I know you guys aren't college watchers. So I'm interested to know if you even give a shit about this game.
No, I don't.
Really? You don't care about it? Huh?
I've never owned a college football game.
Have you tried it? Have you tried a fucking college football game?
I think I played. Somebody had it.
I would think you had to have tried.
Somebody had it. Yeah, I've played it.
I would almost figure because we're starving that you'd go, well, I'll play the fucking college game. It's not like it's fake names or something, you know, where you go, oh, I got LA football.
Like, I don't care.
Yeah.
That's the problem.
I guess. What about you, Greggy boy?
I don't know. I'm apprehensive about getting it just because it's EA football and their track track record with fucking Madden.
Well, they had track record with college. And you know what's funny to
I
me
know,
is
and I did have it back in the day.
I always thought it was
2001
like
or something like that.
The same people made it. So I always thought that. And I'm like, it's the same fucking crew. Why can't they fucking? I'm worried. So I'm like terrified about this, thinking it's going to be, you know, just the makers of Madden. Oh, let's put a different skin on it and we're fucking done. But from all the reviews, everybody keeps saying it's like different than Madden is, and Madden still got its fucking issues somewhat. But the fucking college, the scary thing is people been so fucking hungry for it for how long? I mean, it's fucking 10 years.
Yeah.
And now it's, you go, oh fuck, do you hope? If it was almost exactly the same as whatever the fuck 14 was, and just
graphics upgrades.
And fucking, with 4K, and then you're fucking set and done, that would almost be okay. I saw that somebody was making a high school football game, and I'm like, the more the fucking better, just make football great again, I think. You know, I'm like, because if it's good, I bought that one that had, I think it was Doug Flutie's on the cover. Maximum fucking football or something like that. God,
how long ago was that?
Well, it was like, it's $3 on like PlayStation or something. So I bought it. I literally played it for seconds. It was so fucking shit. Like, they didn't have a crowd. I always say, this is like real fucking XFL or something. I'm like, they didn't have shit. And I'm like, this is just, it was bad. The announcers were better, but other than that, the graphics were shit. Everything was pretty shit about it. So I was a little worried, but people say, oh, don't buy, you know, that bundle together. Or, you know, don't buy without listening to someone you trust first. And I'm like, for me, I'm buying Madden anyway every fucking year. So whatever. I'll fucking
Do the bundle then.
I was thinking I might as well do the bundle. I would like to actually have the physical copy, though. That's what I do like, the actual having the copy in hand. And especially because I've collected all the Maddens, you know, so you kind of like the last few, I don't have the physical copy. And so it's like every 2 years I'll go buy that old one to have, because then it's fucking $10 for, you know, you're buying a box, you know, for $10 and be able to get what the fuck you need. So, I don't know.
Maybe I'll do that in 2 years so I can have a McCaffrey cover.
There you go. So, I'm like, like I said, what's the worst going to happen? Fucking leg sideways up.
New contract, no problem.
I was going to say, what's the worst that could happen? They're going to lose the Super Bowl? And then I was like, well, I guess his leg would be fucking sideways too. That. Yeah, I'm like, that's the least of the fucking bad things that could happen. Oh, shame. I got to the Super Bowl. So, yeah, I was gonna have that on this show where it was let's guess the cover, and that got fucking. It's supposed to be, I think Thursday they announce like the release day, I think, shit like that, and show more stuff. So I'm like, all right, and then of course they fucking bleed that fucking shit out. Nah, after Caleb wins a Super Bowl in his rookie year, they'll put him on the cover next year. Why not?
I do enjoy one of the covers because, you know, they have to have multiple covers.
Because there's 80 deluxes where you can an ultimate team. Fuck you. I can't believe you talked shit and you did ultimate. You ended up doing ultimate, right? That was like you got into that. It was that stupid cards fucking game where cards were.
I don't think. Did I buy the ultimate? Oh.
You started
playing. I did one year by. I think it was the Hall of Fame edition when it was Owens.
I don't even know if I'm talking about you just buying. I remember you talking shit about just what is this stupid shit, and then you
the
played
ultimate
it.
Team, yeah. And then I got into it.
Yes,
yeah. And it was fun. I enjoyed that more than the regular shit. I'm like, oh, cool. I could have Steve Young and Primetime and Owens.
And they were just the cards, right? It wasn't like they were players or they were cards on your screen.
You're making your own team. It's like a fantasy team.
But they actually have them playing. They're not
you're
a
making
playing
your
card.
Own team. So like Steve Young is your quarterback.
Okay.
You're playing with, you can create an all-star team eventually. You just have to grind and go through different challenges to unlock these players. Breath. And then it was like, all right, this was fun. Then the next year's game comes out and you like start over and you're like,
start over.
I'm doing all the same shit again. It's like, why?
I was thinking it was like remember the WWE had their fucking cards fucking game where it was cards fighting each other. Right. That's what I thought this fucking game was. And it was cards on the screen. And I go,
it's
who
a
the
card to, you know, represent the player.
Yeah.
You know, you might have, say, because the show does the same thing.
And so does, NBA does the same thing too with the stupid cards.
I hate that.
Yeah, but then
they're
actual players. You know what I mean? But then there could be different levels. Like you could have, I'm trying to think, like say a Justin Jefferson rookie. So it'd have like his rookie stats and then you would have his current one or like a Jerry Rice. You would have like a rookie one. So maybe he's only like an 85, but then you have like from a different season where he's a 99. It's just, you have to grind and do different challenges to get those players.
Or you could buy them too, right?
Or you could buy them.
See,
I trade off all your shitty ones, you know, like on the show, you would go on, they have like an auction place. So if you were like, but then some of the cards you could only get by doing certain challenges. So there's different shit.
I only bought stuff when I was doing Road to the Show. To get my fucking guy up to, be able to pitch. I'm like,
get
fuck
the attributes up.
Yeah, like fucking getting whooped every fucking. I go, I look like Diaz out here. What the fuck is this? I shrugged. I go, fuck it. Hit home run.
I did my job.
Yeah, like, right, home run. Fuck. Did my job. Threw it right down the middle and he threw it out the fucking park. Fucking Benitez. That was the only ones I fucking did that shit on. But, you know, I'm still playing fucking Madden. And because football doesn't stop, I go all year. And the best part about it is the file sharing where I remember back in the day, I was buying shit on eBay where people would send you a memory card and they would make a fucking draft class. And that's what I would fucking import from the thing. People would
got all the real names.
There. Yeah. And people would sit there and do
that was
fucking
the other thing,
everything.
Right? The old college games. Did they have real names or had just had numbers?
It had
or
numbers.
Then eventually they had like a generic name generator or something.
There was
right?
where you could just say generate names. And like, I know the college basketball one, which is all the college games are fun. It's the atmosphere of the game is so much more fun. Like I was playing college basketball and the fucking crowds fucking jumping in unison and doing their little fucking bullshit cheers. I'm like, it's
I got
way
one of those college,
fun.
Like I think it was the EA college one.
Yes.
I got like cheap. I'm like, oh, this is actually pretty fun.
It had the guy with Ohio State on the cover. I don't even know who the fuck he ended. Yeah, I don't think he turned out to be shit. That was the one I played. And it was like, I remember that generating and I would always do Illinois and my guy's name was Witherspoon. The my center, and I would just, let's go, Clarence. Spoon. I fucking put him in the fucking post. So it was like, they would generate names too in the college one. So eventually, I remember fucking ages ago when it first came out, old Plebeian Pat fucking would make it. And that was when Tim Couch was on fucking Kentucky. And he just, that was the only person you knew. So he would play Kentucky and he would change the name to Couch on him. Everyone else would have a fucking number. You wouldn't know who the fuck, you wouldn't play with Couch. And so then it was just generate names. But then now with all the technology stuff that you could just fucking download the rosters where people have built it, and people get off on, I'm the one who fucking made it. I give a fuck who the fuck makes this fucking thing. You know, the people that are very proud. Oh, you got it from me. All right, great. Mm-hmm. Thanks for putting all your work in, and I don't care. I just take from you. Thumbs up. So it was, I would do that, and they've done it to where now I've done a few years in there, and they've gone through all of the fucking, like, the 4 years of college where the freshmen from this last one are now going to be in the senior class, and you see names that you actually fucking know from some of this college stuff. And then there's ones that make a legend one. So I'm thinking after the 4 years of actual, well, now there's not, now it's all just generated names anyway. I'm like, now maybe I'm going to import the Legends fucking class and have fucking like, Montana and Rice in the fucking draft with Reggie White and fucking crazy shit. I'd be like, fuck, well, the first fucking two rounds, you're going to get 90s from everybody.
Yeah.
Because you know what the fuck they are. You'd be like, oh, look, fucking. And I don't think it's going by class. I think it's just every fucking, you know, Walter and fucking Rice are going to be in the same fucking draft class with fucking Aikman and
imagine
fucking, yeah, I'd be like, all right, who do I pick here? Oh, I'm picking 20th. I'm going to get a fucking blue chip, you know, whatever.
Still 99.
Yeah, there's still going to be 99s in that shit. I'd be like, oh, I'm 20th. I guess I'll pick Reggie White. I guess I got to fucking deal with this. I'm like, I'll trade all my fucking picks, get about fucking 10 second rounders. And fucking get all fucking 90s off of them, too. But I do the play the moments thing because it goes, it, you know, you cruise through a fucking thing and you're not destroying a game because it goes by itself so long. You get in a game, you're like, fuck, I'm getting killed. I have no choice. My team's just getting killed. And even if I fucking score a touchdown here, I'm still fucking behind, you know. So it seems like more of a challenge. I mean, by the time I even get to be able to do the good draft, it'll be the new Madden comes out anyway, so
yeah,
you know. You never got the new baseball, did you?
No, not this year. So.
No, me neither. Now for me, I go, and especially when the Mets are garbage, like, why would I fucking, I've been working on a franchise with this fucking thing, and for baseball, God help you, you can't do more than one fucking year. It's, that is a fucking,
that's rough.
Oh, that's real rough. And you're not, I mean, unless you go, well, I'm going to play one every 10.
Yeah.
Possible then. And even that's still fucking brutal. You go, I'll play one game out of the series. That's fucking, that's a lot.
And that one, you could do, what do they call it? Is it a super sim where you could sim it, but then it's like you play the moments like that on two, right?
So yeah.
It's like, oh, here's a pressure situation. Do you want to play or sim it?
Yeah. I mean, and I haven't done, I stopped doing Road to the Show this year or last year when I got the game. It was the first time I stopped Road to the Show and I actually tried franchise because like I told you, I never played the game actually. I only pitched. I never hit. I never did any of that shit. And so it was like, well, I'll actually, you know, control this. And there is a lot more to it than I remember because then there's that, there's the fucking, you could guard in the off season. It's that, what the fuck did they call that weird? It's a weird draft that's in there where you stake claim on people, but then others could like draft from yours. And it's a real thing that goes on there. What's it called?
Rule five.
There you fucking go. I knew you'd be jerking off to baseball. You'd know what the fuck that was. I'm like, I'm
if
lost.
Not on the 40-man roster. You can draft them, but they have to stay
they
on your roster
be
for
on
the entire
it.
Year.
That's
otherwise,
a motherfucker.
You have to send them back to the other team.
That's a motherfucker. You're like, this guy sucks, but I have to have him. Yeah, that was like, I was like, all right, I'm not taking anybody because nobody was like valuable out there to fucking do it. But tell you that and the fucking what NBA. We always said NBA was like the best fucking game. Of all those to, like, actually play, it was that fucking good. I don't think I'll buy the fucking NBA. I've always done it. Like, I buy the NBA game, and I play for 4 fucking minutes.
Yeah, I downloaded last year's off the PlayStation Store, the Kobe one, the Kobe edition.
Oh, you got the Kobe edition.
And I started playing it, and I'm like, I suck at this. Like, I'm just doing the
There's
practice
too many
stuff.
Buttons with it. It's oh, now to cross over and do a bounce, yeah. A
like
Euro
I'm doing
step.
A tutorial
a Euro step.
Like, okay, I can dunk, but that's about it. I can't. There was some move it wanted me to do. I couldn't figure it out. I'm like, I'm doing what it's.
Oh, that saying. Thing where it says try this in practice. Oh,
yes.
Motherfucker.
And you can't move on until you actually
yep.
do it.
And I've quit. I have totally had that and gone. No, I'm done with this.
I do love that they have all the like legacy teams and you can have like the best of.
That is like, what cool. I did. I did the 2 year ago game or the last year's game where mm-hmm. it was better than what I was able to do on the next game, to where I aligned the fucking divisions with their best fucking year team. Mm. And so, like, you know, you have Shaq versus Shaq, though, when it comes right. down, you know, Orlando versus LA and stuff like mm-hmm. that, and Miami or something. But yeah, LeBron's all over the fucking game. But
three teams.
Yeah, you know. And I was like, which Bulls team do I want to have this on? But I got to do it with Rodman on there, you know, the later years. So I did it with that. But it was, then it was more, you know, it was a lot more fun to be able to do. What they changed is you couldn't do that on the next year. They only let you do the decades or the Bird Magic era, the Jordan era, or the Kobe era.
I noticed that. That's the game I had.
Yeah, and so I did the Jordan years, you know, where it was like, all right, well, you know, I'm going to play with my fucking Bulls, you know. So, but I'm like, I would have rather had, because I had it on. The other game was on the Xbox that I have, the Xbox One, I think, to where it was the actual years that you could choose mm-hmm. from. And it was wild because I'm playing fucking Manute Bowles in this fucking bitch. The first game I had to fucking play, I was like, Jesus Christ, look at this fucking guy.
Look at this tall motherfucker.
Oh, fucking, you just see a smile on the court running down. Like it's like, holy shit, it was that fucking wild. So, oh, fuck, we are about to go into the other side and talk about Greg's movie that I watched while I was on a fucking treadmill. Fucking 2 hours on a fucking treadmill. Just watch that fucking movie all the way through. That's the way to do it. You got to watch something that you're at least halfway into. And I've never seen the movie, and I read with the fucking description. And Greg's movie was Wickerman with a W. And
the remake.
Yes. Yeah. That was the first thing I realized. I was like, hold on a second. I go, 76 or whatever the fuck it was. You know, I'm like, oh, no, that's not.
The the original was streaming somewhere on one of the apps, but the other one
Amazon. It was there for sure. Because I was like, oh, Greg's wrong. It is free on Amazon. And then, oh, wrong free one.
Not the Nick Cage version.
Not the Nicolas Cage. That's the one that we fucking. He really is a bad actor.
Yeah.
It's really something else that it's like, how did you make yourself? But then in certain things, it's like you find them to be good. I don't know. Like Con Air, I think is fantastic. Yeah. I don't know if that's any good of him.
Put the Benny back in the box line fucking kills me every fucking time.
Years ago, me and Rob used to joke around, or maybe it was him that posed the question, like, who's the better actor, Nick Cage or Keanu Reeves? And it used to be a toss up because they're both terrible. But I think Keanu has since proven himself.
He found his groove.
Yeah.
Mm.
Found his lane.
No, but yeah, you're right. Like Kiss of Death, I thought he was really good. Nick Cage.
Really?
That was the one where he was like a kingpin or something like that, and David Crusoe was trying to take him out, and Samuel L. Jackson kept having that
Kiss of
that
Death.
Eye that fucking leaked.
I haven't even seen that one.
Sounds familiar. I can't remember if I saw that one.
Jesus. Yeah, I haven't seen that one either. So we will get Greg's take on his beautiful movie of what he fucking recommended. It was almost like he went, ah, fuck it, here's a movie. That's what it sounded like when he gave it.
What was your reasoning, Greg? I remember you had a reason.
Just because Nicolas Cage is a horrible actor, I think you said.
Yeah. I can't stand him, and this is one of those movies that's been out there for a while that I've never seen, so I wanted to see it. To prove to myself that, yeah, I'm right, he's bad.
Yeah, we'll get into it.
Oh, fuck. All right, let's jump on over, as they say, to the other side. Between the two of you, because this is, I think, a Bay Area thing. Finish the jingle. Who could do it? Western Appliance.
making life much easier for you.
I knew the rhythm, but I didn't know the words.
It's those things. They fucking stick, man.
The sign, the big old sign is still there. It is. That warehouse has been empty forever.
Is it a BMW or a... I thought it was a baby place at first, right?
No, that's on the corner. Yeah. Western Appliance is like next door, two doors down.
Yeah, what the fuck is that one on the fucking corner?
The Babyland, right? Baby. That's what it was.
That's what it was. Then it was Vespa.
Oh, it was Vespa. I knew it was like a motorcycle place. Or
yeah, that old funny. Scooters out there. Oh, all the Italian scooters.
That's great. All right, kids, we will go over there. Remember, patreon.com/LingusMafia. That's where you get all of this nonsense of ours. You can get this stuff in full, in the entirety. I'm going with a movie I think we have all seen, actually. But it'll be good for... I think there's a lot of things to talk about in it when it's my turn here. And very easy to watch and very entertaining to watch. No. This is... No. It's not something I don't think the audience has ever seen. That's what's funny about it.
No.
So maybe they see. It'll be on... I just killed my mic. There you go. Yeah, I bought a DVD fucking thing finally, Faust, to transfer because of the bootleg CDs.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, transfer to the iPad.
There you go.
I was having trouble with I was trying to put Iron Man on it, and I click on the Iron Man, and it has certificates and all kind. I'm like, why can't I fucking transfer this over? I don't fucking know what the fuck is going on. Maybe it can't, but it is a Blu-ray thing.
Marvel was ahead. Said no.
They blocked you.
Maybe, but what the fuck?
You must buy the digital edition, sucker. Yeah,
fuck off with you. You know what? This thing has to have fucking digital. I don't know. That's one of those movies that if it's on, you can always
like looking at those old Blu-rays and says, oh, it comes with the digital version.
Yep.
Must be used by
yes.
January 1st.
2 minutes.
2017.
Yeah.
Damn it.
2017. The feed will go dry. Patreon.com/LingusMafia. Also, of course, at Lingus Mafia, all our nonsense, especially TikTok. That's where you really want to fucking go for nonsense. We will be over there. Hope to see you guys later. And go check out, of course, the Wrestle Lingus Show. That is on the Creative Control Network. That is Smoke and Joe's network, the best network in town, who I can't wait to tell. I'm going to tell Greg on the other side how close we are to being in second place. How close are we possibly to being in second place? All right, kids, we'll see you over there.
You fucking mark!
What? You haven't signed up to patreon.com/LingusMafia yet? Not only will you get the second half of this show on time on Tuesdays, you could also go back in our history for over 500 plus shows, like number 94, where I was on my deathbed.
And I am Fausty Walnuts.
And I'm... have Manning.
Also, by becoming a member of patreon.com/LingusMafia, you are free to send us a submission of your own show and we'll play it like these super fans.
Lingus Mafia podcast family, grab the lube, sit down, and get ready for Creepy Crutchfield, Girls of Porn. Where are they now? The Cocketeer. He's got a motherfucker, he flies around with his dildo jetpack. Do you see your butthole and the vagina, and she's just going to town with her fingers.
WWE pay-per-view previews.
So, gotta be honest, not excited about this.
It's a horror show. It really is a horror show, but not in a good way.
The Duchess and I review Total Bellas, like the time they said they wrote a book.
Stop that, you're gonna make me laugh.
So get on over to patreon.com/LingusMafia and see what you've been missing.
I think I'm gonna have to edit first.
Sits there with the book all proud. They told someone a story. I have the goddamn DVD somewhere in my... I'm thinking I had the case still, but I have a good sample of like favorite movies that I keep the case. All the rest are in the fucking binder, you know.
But
yeah, that one's to look for.
I got an email from Dijon last week, and he sent it like probably a half hour after the show was over.
Oh yeah.
So he suggested a movie, and I saw the movie he suggested, and I don't even think it would be one. Maybe after this cycle we could do, because it's, I don't even think we need to review it because we've all seen it probably many times.
Okay.
Many times. I almost feel like we did review it in a way. It's something like we could just maybe break it up, just read the box cover and then just talk about our favorite shit. So,
well, what is it?
I will let you know. I heard Fausti mentioning getting requests for viewers for Movie of the Week segment, but I'm behind on the pod, so I don't know if that has changed. Anyways, I'm still going to suggest a movie. I feel like you guys, best reviews are when it's 80 movies you grew up on. So here is the 90s movies.
Mm.
Mallrats by the fabulous Kevin Smith.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, we've done Mallrats. We've totally done Mallrats. Mall yeah, I believe so.
I don't remember.
Yeah, we could discuss that. That's
P.S. I watched Late Night with the Devil, and it was fantastic. And shout out to Greg for mentioning it a couple times a couple weeks ago. It's dope. Mustard out.
Are we ready to try a pickle?
What is that one?
Great. It just came out. It's but like a late night show format. Mm. And it's kind of like The Exorcist. It's like if The Exorcist was on the...
Or it's,
no. Nope. Bunch of small people, but it is really good.
Mm. Let's try one of the pickles. I know like you midget? Can't see it. You can't see it on camera, but my pickle is brownish.
Mm.
So let's have a bite. And you will see it's a carbonated pickle.
So crunchy.
Yeah. A little sweetness, but still a lot of the salt and vinegar.
And it's got that sizzle to it because of the carbonation. So
yeah. Yeah, it does.
Mm. Not too shabby. Not too shabby. All right, kids. We are getting the fuck out of here as usual. Hope you enjoyed the show. Tell a friend. Everybody needs to know about
friend.
The Lingus Mafia podcast, which is our fuck around show at this point. And then me and Fausti will be doing the other show, which is world fucking renowned. They know us in, where was it, Fausti? Cambodia, right? That was where.
Number one in Cambodia.
Number one in Cambodia. That's why. You didn't know? All right, kids. Remember, I could do anything I want because my dad is dead. And we'll see you next Tuesday.
You're either Lingus or against us.
But together, we're assholes.
Best podcast in the world.
I am the best on this microphone. Nobody can touch me.
Yours truly.
I'm done. Show's over. Good day.
Fade to black.